So hello everybody.
We're back.
I'm being joined today by my very good friend Becky Cohen. I love this. I get to choose who to interview. That's so obnoxious.
You're going to interview me right now.
All right.
So awesome. I'm ready to be interviewed.
Sweet. So dancing mindfulness, will it help me to learn the Macarena?
If that's your intention, which really is all about intention.
Oh, I like it. So it's not specific dances.
No.
It's more how to dance.
Well, the whole dancing mindfulness mission is about respecting that everybody's a dancer. That it's not about mastering steps. It's about using dance as a way to be in the moment, as a way to connect with emotion, as about a way to connect with anything that you intend to connect with. So I always tell people, if you like to just dance around your house, what we're really doing in this book is celebrating that as a legitimate meditation practice.
Awesome.
And the main audience of the book are people who are just interested in cultivating personal practice. Like if you want to teach it a great guru, or you want to see it as some larger template, that's fine too. But don't let these societal messages
awesome.
A la you can't dance stop you from bringing it in as part of your wellness practice.
So rather than dance as if nobody's watching, dance as if somebody is watching. Come on, that was my thought. So can I just share one thing with you about dancing? Because this is really powerful for me. So we do these trainings. And we invite people to write a letter to their father. Over the course of the different trainings. But we also say, we really encourage you to do something artistic. So we were in Baltimore 3 years ago, we did this training, and a woman said, I'm gonna do interpretive dance, an interpretive dance. And my colleague and I were both like, oh, are you kidding me? And I swear to God, she started the dance. Before I knew it, I had tears in my eyes, and I was just so present with her, watching as she was moving and like acting out the addiction in that process. So to me, that sounds like that's exactly what you're doing.
What has been an honor to see how many recovering women are doing? Expressing things
in the last
and I'm also happy to know that more people.
Good.
It's funny, whenever I teach this at a conference, it's always happy.
Awesome.
So if they're given a sense, they're going to do it.
That's right.
They're going to be judged. And that's a big part of what we promote in the dance and mindfulness practice, that this is a safe space. If you're here to judge or critique,
that's
not
what you're doing. Yourself out there over.
What was your favorite part about writing this book?
Consulting with you.
Oh, thanks.
Awesome. One of my favorite parts. But seriously, I think collaborating with others, because I was as mindful as conscious as possible about getting others' experiences and sharing them. We have a lot of individuals from our own dance and mindfulness community, facilitators, dancers who come forward, and I wanted other voices to share. First book I've ever done that's truly for a general audience. And that was special.
To be
edited through that to realize, wait, maybe it's better applicability. Because I think I've carried some of these things. Oh, I don't write the books. This message.
I'm excited to read it.
And I'm excited to have both of you here today. Just chatting about dancing mindfulness. And
Awesome.
So,
I don't know how to go.
Okay.